So Darin, I was talking to you after we did that pilot intro video about valve cant, and I said, you know what, let's just see if we can make a shorter, we'll make a quick video to talk about valve cant, because that seems to be popular and it's going to be more popular. You know, how much valve cant is too much? You know, I think a pro stock probably has a couple degrees. What do they have? What's a scoop on that?
Well, it depends on a lot of factors, and generally, I'm a modern pro stock heads have 2.5, maybe 3 degrees of cant. Okay. Not a lot. And if you look at the valves, you know, and you have them just straight up and down, okay, this, and then you angle them back, let's say 10 degrees. Okay, so that's a 10-degree cylinder head or a 12-degree cylinder head. Yeah. And from that point, what you would do is cant is the display outside, okay? As you do that, look what happens to the center of the chamber. It gets deeper.
Deep, yeah.
Okay, so cant will set your chamber depth, number one. And two, a wedge head like this is, as you cant the valves, you have to shrink the valve size because they run into each other.
Yes.
So as you decrease cant, you can put a bigger valve in there for more valve area.
Right.
Okay, but there's a certain area right there, and it's a very small area, and this R&D was done over 30 years, and all the pro stock heads, we've been everywhere from 0 to 7 degrees, and every single time we went past 4, 4.5 degrees, every time we went past 4, let's just say 4 degrees of cant, it was a disaster. Every single time we did a cylinder head with 6 or 7 degrees of cant, it would not wind up. It would not work properly. It killed the intake port efficiency, because what you're doing is you have a port that's lined up with the valve.
Yeah.
And then you cant it 4 degrees. Well, you can cant that port a little bit. That's fine. And now you go 6. Well, now you're having to turn that air into the combustion chamber even harder. You have a more offset port, so you're instilling a higher velocity gradient in there. The side-to-side velocities are mismatched horribly. And it just, the port efficiency, the flow drops, you can't, it just, functionally, it won't work over 4 degrees. I've never seen a cylinder head, personally, function properly over 4 degrees of cant. And as you rotate the valves, let's say you had 4, 4.5 degrees here, as you rotate them around more like a Hemi, that cant will slowly come out of them, too.
Okay.
But see, what you're trying to do, you're playing around here with, is you're trying to get the most valve area you can as efficiently as you can with a sufficient chamber depth to put the spark plug there to form a ball over the combustion chamber to burn all the fuel efficiently. So somewhere in there lies that perfect geometry to make everything function. And as you rotate the valves around, it gets harder and harder and more difficult to manage all those. So a wedge is the worst possible. Slightly rotated is better. Slightly rotated canted is optimal, like a Cleveland or a Pro Stock engine or a big block Chevy, something that has some rotation and a little cant. And what they've done there is they've manipulated the valve positions to where the valve train is not only in line, which is definitely something you have to look at, because you can't just cant the valve off. And one of the reasons that they cant valves is for to line the valve train up. So when you've rotated the valve too far, now you have to rotate the valve over to line up the rocker arm, and you have too much cant. So basic rule of thumb is any more than 4 degrees, you're in dangerous territory.
There it is.